Welcome back to our brand new series, Anatomy Dissected by Complete Anatomy. Continuing on with our cranial nerve series, it's now time to take a look at cranial nerve 3, the oculomotor nerve. In this video, we'll first explore the pathway of this nerve, examine the muscles it innervates and their functions, and finish off by looking at some of the clinical correlates. Let's start at the brainstem, where a collection of both somatic and visceral motor axons exit on the anterior surface as the oculomotor nerve. From here, the nerve runs anteriorly in the subarachnoid space, piercing the dura and passing through the wall of the cavernous sinus. Upon exiting the cavernous sinus, the oculomotor nerve runs below the lesser wing of the sphenoid bone to enter the orbit through the superior orbital fissure. As the nerve enters the orbit, it divides into its superior and inferior branches. Both branches will pass into the orbit within the boundaries of the common tendinous ring. From here, the superior and inferior branches will pass anteriorly to supply the extraocular muscles of the eye. As we said already, this nerve carries both somatic and autonomic nerve fibers. Somatic functions of the nerve include movement of the eye and eyelid. The muscles that are innervated by the oculomotor nerve are the levator palpebrae superioris muscle, which is responsible for elevating the eyelid, the superior rectus muscle, which predominantly moves the eyeball superiorly or elevates it, the inferior rectus muscle, primarily depresses and adducts the eyeball, the medial rectus muscle, adducts the eyeball, moving it towards the midline. Finally, the inferior oblique muscle elevates, abducts, and laterally rotates the eyeball. Autonomic functions of cranial nerve 3 include control of the pupil and lens. Innervation to the sphincter pupillae muscle allows for pupil constriction. This nerve also innervates the ciliary muscles, which when contracted alters the curvature of the lens and allows an individual to focus. Like all other nerves in the human body, the oculomotor nerve can be damaged. Though it has a relatively protected course through the base of the skull and in the orbit, it has a number of vulnerable points. Increased pressure in the cavernous sinus can force the nerve against other structures, causing it to become compressed. An aneurysm of the posterior communicating artery can apply local pressure to the nerve, close to its emergence from the brainstem, reducing its functionality. Compression or damage to the nerve results in oculomotor nerve palsy, which commonly presents as ptosis, a down and outward gaze, and mydriasis in the affected eye. So that's it. Hopefully now you have a much better understanding of cranial nerve 3. You should now be able to discuss the pathway of the nerve from the anterior surface of the brainstem all the way to the muscles. You should now be able to identify the muscles that rely on this nerve and their functions. And you should be familiar with some of the clinical features and causes of cranial nerve 3 damage. Remember to stay tuned for the rest of our series on cranial nerves. Hit the like button below and subscribe for more top-class anatomy content.